Have you ever wondered why you're able to achieve some goals so easily and others never seem to happen with you? The way we connect and engage with our goals has a big bearing on whether they become reality for us or continue to be a faraway dream. Particularly with health and fitness, we tend to engage through the weaknesses that we perceive ourselves to have. We ask ourselves the question, are you unfit and unhealthy? Then you need to exercise. Are you overweight and unmotivated? You need to exercise. We not only put this pressure on ourselves, but the advertising and society tends to put that pressure on us as well. By connecting to your health and fitness goals in this way, through compliance, research shows we are setting off negative emotional attractors in our mind. This is all about defensiveness, threat, guilt, and a feeling of fight or flight response. This is a terrible way to connect with our health and fitness goals and affects whether we're going to be able to achieve them or not. So this time when you start your health and fitness journey, ask the question, what do you want to be, rather than what do you need to do? By coaching yourself with compassion can lead to enabling positive emotional attractors in our mind, which is all about health for the future, optimism, joy, and looking at our goals in a more positive way. This is how we want to start our health and fitness journey, thinking about what it means to us. Is it about playing with your grandchildren in the park? Is it about sport? Is it about enjoying your young family? Is it about chasing your dreams? So before starting your health and fitness journey this time, connected to the perceived weaknesses you believe you have, ask yourself, what opportunities can I create today through my health and fitness?